Hi dear students, this is your Swapna ma'am. In this video I'll help you to understand the second lesson 2 deer of your course book Springs. 2 deer is written by Leo Tolstoy, who was a famous Russian writer. He is regarded as one of the greatest novelists and a master of realistic fiction. It was published in 1897. And it is a humorous account of the troubles of dealing with a criminal in a small kingdom. Too dear means too expensive. This story is a satire on the entire political system of a small kingdom and its law and power. The story is set in a tiny kingdom named Monaco. The first sentence of this lesson is, near the borders of France and Italy, on the shore of the Mediterranean Sea, lies a tiny little kingdom called Monaco. The writer calls this Monaco kingdom a tiny and a little one. This is a toy kingdom because only 7,000 inhabitants were there in this Monaco kingdom. As other kingdoms, this Monaco kingdom has a real kinglet. Kinglet means a minor king. And he has a palace, courtiers who were helping this king, ministers who had a lot of responsibilities, a bishop, generals and an army. The army consists only 60 men. In Monaco kingdom, there are taxes on tobacco, wine, spirit and a poll tax. The kinglet of this Monaco kingdom was suffering to feed his courtiers, his officials and to keep himself. He had to get a special revenue. The special revenue comes from a gaming house where people play roulette. People play. Whether they win or lose, the keeper of the gaming house always gets a percentage on the turnover, and out of his profits he pays a large sum to the prince. In other German sovereigns used to keep this gaming house many years ago, but they had stopped this one because these gaming houses did so much harm to the people. People lost money, people lost health, people lost peaceful family life. A man would come and try his luck. Then he would risk all he had, lose it. In despair, he would run or shoot himself. So the Germans forbade their rulers to make money in this way. But the Prince of Monaco, he remained with a monopoly of this business. Only in Monaco kingdom this dirty business was going on. In the third paragraph, the writer brings a proverb, you can't earn stone palaces by honest labor. This is a comment of this kinglet of this Monaco kingdom. He knows these gaming houses or the gamblings are vice, and it is a dirty business and it has a lot of negative impact on people who play. But he says that honest labor does not bring enough money, so it is okay to bend the law a bit and allow gambling to thrive so that the revenue of the kingdom multiplies. His belief was like that. So he was keeping this gaming house, whether he knows already it is a dirty business. By that time also he became the monopoly of this dirty business. And he was getting money from these taxes and this special revenue. And he has his coronation. Coronation means ceremony of crowning. His levies. Levies means official reception of girls, especially from foreign countries. So all these functions he was doing well, as other countries had done, and he had rewards, sentences and pardons, and he also has his reviews, councils, laws, courts of justice, everything. How one king has to do all the works, the same way he also was doing in his small kingdom, but it was on a smaller scale. So the life of the people and the kinglet was going very smoothly. One day, one murder happened in the small kingdom. Before that, the people of this Monaco kingdom, they were leading a peaceable life. Such a thing had not happened here. After this murder, what happened? The judges, prosecutors, jurymen, barristers, everybody assembled. They argued, they judged. Finally, they came into one conclusion. The criminal has to be executed and his head should be cut off. And this sentence they present in front of the prince. Prince agreed and he told, if the fellow must be executed, execute him. After this, a lot of interesting incidents are coming in the story. There was a hitch in this matter. Hitch means H-I-T-C-H. Hitch means problem. There was a hitch in this matter. Monaco, there was no guillotine and an executioner. Guillotine means the equipment which is using to cut the head of the criminal, and there was no expert to do it. The ministers decided to ask the help of French government, and they wrote a letter to the King of France. Reply came, a machine and an executioner could be supplied and the cost would be 16,000 francs. The prince and his council of ministers felt it was too expensive. Next letter they wrote to Italian government. The king of Italy was the brother monarch, but he replied that 12,000 francs to be paid for guillotine and executioner, including traveling expense. Although this was a cheaper than French offer, the prince and his council discarded this idea. They discussed and considered how it could be done with less expense. The general was called and he was asked, can you find us a soldier who could cut the man's head off? The general discussed with his soldiers, but the soldiers replied that they didn't know how to do it. It was not a thing they had been taught. What was to be done? Again, the ministers considered and reconsidered, and they decided to alter the death sentence to one of the imprisonment for life. This would enable the prince to show his mercy and it would come cheaper. So here we can see first the kinglet and his ministers, they decided to give death punishment for this criminal, but they have no guillotine and they have no executioner. So they decided to alter, they decided to change the death punishment to life imprisonment. Again, they are facing another problem. What is that? In Monaco kingdom, there was no suitable prison for a man sentenced for life. There was a small lockup which was not strong fit for permanent use. But somehow they managed and put this young criminal there and placed a guard over him. So they appointed one guard for this, to watch this man. The guard had to watch the criminal and fetch his food from palace kitchen. That was the duty of this guard of this criminal. After 1 year, one day the king was looking over the account of income and expenditure. He noticed that a new item of expenditure. It was about more than 600 francs. He checked thoroughly. What was that? It was for keeping the criminal, the guard and the man's food. So the prince summoned his ministers and said to them, this present plan is too expensive. They could not afford this one. Ministers reconsidered this matter and decided to dismiss the guard. They thought, in the absence of the guard, the criminal will run away. So the guard was dismissed. Everyone waited to see what would happen. The next day, in dinner time, the criminal came out of the prison. He went directly to the palace kitchen, fetched his food, returned to the prison, shut the door by himself and stayed inside. The next day also the same thing occurred. The criminal did not show the least sign of running away from here. Finally, the ministers, the councils, they decided to talk with this criminal. They wanted to know why this criminal is not running from here. The criminal was reluctant to go out of the prison because he knew his reputation and had been tarnished and wouldn't get a job or respect in the society if he goes outside. Besides, he did not have any other place to go. Again, the ministers, the king and his council came in trouble. The only way to get rid of him was to offer him some pension. See, what is the condition of this government? A man committed a murder. Actually, if the government is a powerful one, they have to give the correct punishment for this criminal. But here, the lack of guillotine and an executioner, they altered that their decision to life imprisonment. And that also they could not afford. And finally, they are talking with to give some pension to this criminal. The pension fixed was 600 francs, lucky fellow, this criminal. This was announced to the prince. He also agreed. So the matter was settled. The criminal received 1/3 of his annuity in advance and left the kingdom. And he settled just across the frontier, bought a bit of land and started the market gardening. And whenever he wanted to play roulette, he will come to the gaming house, he will play, and he was leading a peaceful life there. Dear students, in this story, the writer Leo Tolstoy has satirically pointed out how the justice system works and how politicians do not prioritize in the right way. Really, he is raising one question against the government. Why are the king and the council of ministers okay with the gambling as a source of revenue but reluctant about spending money on justice? How can immoral rulers decide what is right for the criminal? Really, in this kingdom, king is supporting a gambling game and he knows that it is a dirty business, but he was continuing that one. So how he can decide about this criminal's punishment? How can immoral rulers, and Leo Tolstoy is pointing out the rulers of this kingdom Monaco itself, immoral one, and how they can decide what is right for the criminal? And why are the people of Monaco quiet about the decisions made by the king? So he is asking one question against this people of Monaco. Why these people are not questioning about this government? Is money everything? In conclusion, one may say that Tolstoy questions and mocks the foolish and disorganized behavior of those in power through this short story. I hope you have understood about this lesson, Two Deer by Leo Tolstoy. Thank you, students.